said, who is praying for the sicarios? A sicario is a hitman that is hired by the mafia to kill people. They pay to them $50 for every person they kill. So we said, church, let's pray and adopt sicarios. Let's pray for them. Let's bless them. Let's ask God to change their lives. A week later, I receive a phone call from a member of my church, and he says, his name is Arturo, and Arturo says the following, Pastor, 5 years ago, I came to a prison in the United States because I was dealing drugs. The Lord saved me in that prison, and he asked me to pray for the meanest guy on that prison. I prayed for that man. That man gave his life to the Lord, and sooner or later, both of us got out of the prison. Arturo came to our house, and the other man went to his old town, and he became a sicario. He was working with the cartel before, so he became a sicario. Not only a sicario, but he became the leader of 80 sicarios in the region. This guy, his job responsibility was to talk to these 80 sicarios, train them, and send them to kill people. And he was covering about 25% of the borderline between Mexico and the United States. And the Lord speaks to Arturo and says, Arturo, I want you to go and look for this man. I want you to go and tell him that I love him, that he's my son, that I want him back in the family. And Arturo obeys, and he knows that he has to go and look for him. So he goes to this town, and he looks for this guy whose name is Oscar. And if you go to a small town which is controlled by the cartel, and you ask for this guy who is the head of the killers, I mean, that's not a good idea. You're going to end up with a bullet in your head. So, but this guy is obeying God. So Arturo went, and he's praying, and he knows what's going on. And he gets there, and the first man, he looks crossing a street, he stops and he goes and he says, hey, I'm looking for Oscar. Can you tell me where he lives? And the other guy turns around and he said, what are you wanting for? And Arturo's knees are shaking. And he said, well, I met him in prison 5 years ago. He gave his life to the Lord and God sent me to rescue him. And this man says, oh, this is good news. I am his brother. So because he, by God's divine appointment, he goes with his brother, knocks on this house, and Oscar opens the door. Now, if Arturo would have come to that door and would knock on the door, he's dead. Because nobody looks for these guys except somebody that wants to kill them, unless they have their own codes and all that, that which they are experts on that. But this is his brother. So he says, Oscar, this guy says that he knows you. And Oscar and Arturo says, yes. And Oscar remembers him. And Arturo says, Oscar, Jesus loves you. He wants you back. He wants you to stop doing what you're doing. He wants you in your arms. And then Oscar remembers, and they start talking. And he said, and Oscar is saying, did you come all the way from Juarez to tell me this? Yes. Did you risk your life to come to tell me this? And Arturo said, yes. And he was touched. So he said, can we pray for you? And then Oscar said, yeah, but let's not do it here, because he was having a meeting with 8 sicarios, and when they were planning more killings. So he said, not here. So they walked 2 blocks away from where they are. And as soon as they start praying, 2 death squads came to that house where Oscar just left. About 15 people got out of the car, got inside, and they killed the 8 sicarios that were there. God saved Oscar's life in a perfect timing. So next thing, Oscar is on his knees. And then Arturo, he's telling me this, and he's saying, Poncho, he wants to come to church. And then I'm thinking, this is a man that for sure is in the hit list, not at the bottom, maybe at the top of this cartel. And he wants to come to our church. So I said, you know what? I need to talk to the church. I need to be responsible and talk to the church. I prayed. And when I prayed, I said, God, what do we do? There already have been killings already in 2 Catholic churches, inside of the church. There was this groom, he was getting married. One of his friends was involved in one of the cartels. The other cartel knew about it. They're together getting into the church to get married. One death squad comes, they kill the man that they were looking for, and in the children, the groom is dead. The day of his wedding. They have done that twice. So I'm thinking, Lord, if Oscar comes to our church, it can happen in the street, in our parking lot, or inside our building. What should we do? And I pray, and God says, the Church of Jesus Christ doesn't close its doors to anybody. I already died for sinners. And this is my son, and you are his family, and you are receiving him. So I talked to the church, and I said, this is what's happening. We started praying for Sicarios. We got the first one, a big one. And guess what? He's coming. And I said, church, this is dangerous. Something can happen here. It can happen right here. It can happen in the parking lot. It can happen anywhere, anytime. So we are going to open the doors for this man. I'm not going to tell you who he is. You're not going to know who he is. He may be sitting next Sunday beside you, in front of you, behind you. You're not going to know. So if you don't have the faith, if you struggle, you are free to make a decision. You know how many people we left? We left the church? Zero. Up to this day. Amen. Yes. Yes. Oscar has been coming to church. Last week, my daughter asked me, so Dad, who's Oscar? And said, anybody can be Oscar. Because we all were Oscars. And Jesus died for our sins. And Jesus saved us. So there's no difference. My wife doesn't know who Oscar is. This is Oscar. So next time you see him, maybe you can recognize him.